Hi, it's Carly McAvoy. I'm talking about area, and I already did one video, so this one's a follow-up video to that. I just have the formulas up there in case you're interested in looking at those. We're going to need the formula for a triangle, which is base times height divided by 2, and we're going to need the formula for a rectangle, which is length times width. So here's the shape that they ask you to find the area of the shape, and it's actually two shapes. You can see very distinctly there is a rectangle and then there's a triangle. So let's do the rectangle part first. So for the rectangle, we have length times width, and the length of that is 9 and the width is 3. So I know for the rectangle part I have 27 and it's centimeters, so it's centimeters squared. All right, and then I want to do the triangle part. So this is the rectangle, and this is the triangle. The problem with that is that the triangle formula is base times height divided by 2, or 1/2 base times height. Well, I don't know the base because it didn't tell me that. It does tell me the height is 2, but what is this part? Well, I know that this entire base is 9, so if I come down like this, I can see that this part would be 9 minus what's over here and what's over there. What's over here is 2.5, and what's over here is 2.5, and I know that 2.5 plus 2.5 is 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 2/2 make 5. And so this part in here must be 4, because this is 2.5, and this is 2.5, and the other part must be 4, which tells me that I have a base for my triangle that's 4, because that could slide straight up there, right? So I have 4 times the height of 2 divided by 2. And that's just 8 over 2, or 4, and that is centimeters squared. So the entire area of this shape is going to be 27 plus 4, or 31 centimeters squared. All right, what about the next one? Well, the next one is at a different kind of shape, but again, we're wanting to find two pieces sort of to put them together, because what we have here is two rectangles, right? And so I want to think about maybe this is one rectangle and then this is the second rectangle. So if I want to find, let's say, this rectangle first, well, that's easy because I can see it's 10 by 15 or 15 by 10, and that's length times width, and that's going to be 150, right? 150 what? Well, this is miles, so miles squared. What about this rectangle? Well, here, I don't want to go all the way across 22. I want to stop right here. But if you look up here, this is 10. If you think about taking that and sliding it straight down, that means that this part is 10. And since I'm looking at the part over here, then I say, well, the whole thing is 22. If this is 10, then this part must be 22 minus 10, or 12. And so now I can find the area of this rectangle because it's 12 times 8. And you don't have to do anything in your head. If you want to use the calculator to take 22 minus 10, that's fine. Or if you want to come and do 12 times 8, that's fine. Whatever you're comfortable with doing in your head is fine. But remember, you're allowed to use a calculator. So if you make calculation mistakes in your head, then use your calculator. So now I want to find the area of the entire shape, and I found the first one and the second one. So now I want to add those two together. And so I had 96, and I'm going to add 150, and that's going to give me 246. And that is the area of the entire shape, 246 miles squared, or square miles. Okay, a couple of more on this one. What would be the area of the shape in number 2. Well, that's the one we just did, so let me bring that back. For number 2, we did this one. And now they're saying, what would be the area of that shape if the dimensions had been given in inches? So all I'm asking there is, if this had said, instead of miles, had said inches, would that have changed our calculation in any way? No, but it would have changed our answer, because instead of having miles squared, we would have inches squared. So all I'm looking for there is that you would say, well, if this had been inches instead of miles, then I would have 246 inches squared, if that's the dimension I've been working with. So here's the interesting part of that question then. The second part says to convert your answers from inches squared to feet squared. So, okay, here's where you need to know that the formulas for converting, and I'm going to bring back this from another, from earlier. If you have square units, there's 144 square inches in 1 square foot. So that's what you have to use to make that conversion. Why is that? Well, you know that a foot has 12 inches. So if this was 1 foot, that's 12 inches. If this was a square foot, then it'd be 12 inches along one side and 12 inches along the other side. And what we've been seeing is that 12 times 12, inches times inches, is going to be inches squared. So there's 144 square inches. If this was 1 foot on one side, that'd be 12 inches and 12 inches. So that's the conversion. And here's how we're going to do that. We're going to take and write a 1 under that. We want to get rid of inches squared, so that goes on the bottom. And we want to end up with feet squared, so that goes on top. And then we use our conversion. There is 1 square foot for every 144 square inches. So that's how we would do that conversion. The inches squared on the bottom and top are going to cancel. And then you can just write this in decimal form. And I'm going to take 246 and divide by 144. And that's going to give me 1.7083333. I'm going to round that to the nearest, let's say, tenth. No, let's say 100th. So I'm going to go out to 1.71. And that is square feet, because we had, that's what we were trying to turn end up with, so we have that when we're finished. So this is just a way to convert between square inches and square feet. Okay, number 4, the dimensions of an entryway of a 1-bedroom apartment measure 9.5 by 10 feet. So pretty close to a square there. We'll say this is 9.5 feet and this is 10 feet. How many square feet of tile would be needed for 4 such entryways? Well, I'm just going to find the area, which is going to be length times width. And so that's going to be 9.5 times 10, which is 95, but it's feet squared because it's always squared when we're doing area. And then if I needed to do 4 of those, I would just say, well, I need to multiply times 4 because I need to do 4 of those. So 95 times 4, and that's 380. So I would need 380 square feet of tile if I was going to do 4 of those. And the last one, I took a picture from your homework because I couldn't draw one myself that was as nice. But the question is, how many square feet of land are in this plot? And what you need to recognize here is that this little squares tell you that's 90 degrees and this is 90 degrees. So what you really could do is just drop a straight line down here and get a rectangle. Mine didn't look too much like a rectangle. And then you have a triangle. And so if this is 100 feet, then this is 100 feet. And this part would be then 20 feet. And then you want to know the base and the height of your triangle. But since this is a rectangle, we know 70 feet, so we know that's 70 feet. So now we can find the area of the rectangle. And that is 100 times 70, which is 7 with 3 zeros, or 7,000 square feet. And then we can find the area of the triangle, which is base times height divided by 2. So we have a base of 20 and a height of 70, but we have to divide that by 2, and that's going to be 700. You don't have to do that in your head. You can do it always on your calculator, and then divide. Whoops, we don't want to divide. Multiply, divide by 2, and that gives you 700 square feet. And so if I add those two parts together, I get 7,700 square feet. That's the area of that plot of land. All right, thanks, and have a great day.